the game. What up, guys? Charles Mackerel jumping back into Big Ambitions. All right, guys, we are moving on up in the world. We about to rent us a small office building. We got our gift shop going. We got our burger shop going. Right now, the burger shop isn't making a lot of money because I'm training the employees. Instead of letting them sit there and work, they're training. And once they're done training, we're gonna put them in there. That should help us to earn more money. Good customer service definitely makes a difference in this game. So sometimes it's good to either train them up to a certain level. I say at least 50%, maybe 60, or just go ahead and do it all the way to the 100. If you want to run your shops, especially if they're profitable, like the gift shops, I say get two employees, let one work multiple days in a row and go train the other one, and then bring that one in on the later end, we'll say the latter end of the week, and then train your first employee. That helps you to get the training and minimize your loss in your earnings and in your profit, all right? So what we'll do now, because we need an office space, we're going to see where the office spaces are located. Okay, so we see around here, let's see, that has 10 in foot traffic, which I don't think really makes a difference as you're going for your headquarters. That's 40, let's see, the whole 50 people. I'm thinking this is how many people it'll hold. This one is 10, this one is 4. All right, we're gonna stay fairly local, so we wanna choose one of these two. It'd be great if you could rent out more of the space. Let's look at this to see if we can get a little more information. This one has a customer capacity of 50, okay. Traffic index of 40. Now, being that this is our headquarters, it really shouldn't matter about customer capacity or traffic index. I don't know that for sure, but that makes sense to say. Plus, the deposit is $4,300, almost 44, and it's 146 per month. Whereas this one is only 71 a month and it's only 2,000, so it's basically like half the price. The capacity is smaller, but the traffic index is still very good. But again, it's not a retail store, so that shouldn't matter. I'll find out, but that shouldn't matter. This is our first one and we wanna minimize costs. We're gonna go down here and we're going to open the shop up. All right, chill. Now, hopefully we have enough money. Oh, yes, the down payment. Oh, the down payment was like 2 G's. Oh, you gotta pay all this to rent it. So you have to put down the deposit, the electrical, and the rent in the beginning. So we really need like 28-ish. Oh, all right. Well, we learned something new, guys. So what I'm gonna do, we're gonna, oh, the Porsche done hit me. Look at that, I'm running away from my car. What we'll do then, we'll go ahead and work, because I'm losing a little bit of money on the burger shop right now. But it's just because of how I'm managing it. I'm only working 4 hours some days. So it's just losing money because we're paying bills on it. The gift shop is what is really supporting us right now. I'm gonna go here and we're gonna work all day. It's already 11 o'clock, but we're gonna work all day at the burger joint and try to turn us a profit here. That's gonna make this money till we get tired. Hopefully that 8 hours will generate a decent profit. I'm gonna get some chairs once I rent the office building. We'll see what it's like with chairs in this piece. We might do that first, but we wanna go ahead and get our office going. So let's go on the time machine to the end of this shift. Oh, I wanted to stop it because I wanted to get those people back training, doggone it. All right, I can do one more round of training for Michelle. We'll get up to 76. Bam, let's confirm that. Trav is at 61. We're gonna go ahead and train him one more day. We want his customer service to be tip top on par. If we look at the Econo view, we made 1400 from the gift shop, 200 from the burger joint. That's pretty good money, guys. We're getting there, we are getting there. And it's gonna be even better once we get our employee back, and that will allow me to make more moves like running the show, getting more business, and doing things like opening our office. So we're at 3750. That's great, that's great, that's good money. And we wanna do two things, actually. We do wanna get chairs. We want to get more stock, but first we have to go ahead and get our building. So let's go ahead, let's open this in BizMan. Now we can rent our new building, bam. We want to start a new business. We're starting our headquarters. So again, this doesn't make any money, I believe. This will be Macro Industries. This is the industry that's taking off. We taking over the world. We going global. but we starting right here in the city. All right, so we need to hire a purchasing agent. We need to place a desk in the headquarters and assign a purchasing agent to the workstation. So what I need to do is buy another computer, a desk, and a chair. And that means I'm gonna have to save some money. So that's actually gonna take a couple days. So I'm gonna grind and we're gonna come back to this. I am gonna go ahead to the,
Congratulations on your new headquarters. This is where the top employees of your organization.
All right, I'm talking. We need to purchase an agent. I am going to go to, we'll go right here. This is actually another appliance store. I usually go to the one on the other end, but we're gonna go to this appliance store. You know what? I need chairs though. I don't think they have chairs. I think I'm gonna have to go to the IKEA spot. Let's run in and take a look and see if they happen to have chairs in here. No, they don't. They do have some other things we could buy for our restaurant. They don't have chairs. So while I'm waiting to make more income, I'm gonna go ahead and buy a few chairs just to help out in the burger joint. And I see if we can hire a purchasing agent. We may have to go to a different place. Let me hit this recruitment corp. Let's call them. Let's see, for macro industries, cleaning, no. This isn't where we need to go. So we're gonna have to go to a different agency. So we'll find that. It looks like we're gonna have to go to a different firm to get us an employee. The one that we deal with right now, they don't hire what we need. We need an office type of person, and they only do more of like the retail side of a recruitment. So I'm gonna just run in here. I'm gonna just get a couple chairs for now. What we'll do, cause we made a pretty good profit, we'll go ahead and get us four chairs. I wanna get a table too. So we'll just start with chairs and we'll get more tables as needed or if need be. All right, cool. Yeah, we got 500 left. So we'll have a couple G's when we get done. We'll buy us another computer setup. I would've did that now, but again, I don't have enough. We just need more money. So I'll do something that's gonna make us more money in the interim, and then we'll come back to that, guys. All right, guys, I got my hand truck. We're back here at the restaurant. We're gonna run these in here, and let's go ahead and set up some chairs for these people to eat. They need a better way to keep getting your stuff off and placed. Like, it needs one of those things where I can just keep placing one after the other instead of having to continue to click, then hit P, then click back on the hand truck, then click P. They need to work that out. So I put our hand truck back up, and then I'm gonna sign myself. We're gonna work in the biz for now. We're gonna go ahead and open up the store once again, and we're gonna see if we can maximize our profits. I'm gonna do another 8-hour shift. I'm gonna time machine for a moment, but I wanna make sure I don't miss when the training ends for my new employee. All right, reach 75% any one employee. Whoa, that is another achievement. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Now, because that's the last day we can afford for that person to be gone on the schedule, because it's about to be Thursday, we need to put her back on the schedule, which we'll do. Luckily, the hours are still there. Now, one thing you gotta make sure you don't do with the scheduling is make sure you put them on the register. If you put them on cleaning, I've done this multiple times where I put them on cleaning, the store opens, and you're not getting any service. So what I gotta do is go back to Michelle. So she's at 76%, which reaching 75 has to be a good tier, because 50% appeared to be a tier, 75 and then 100. So those probably help to increase at those certain points with your customer satisfaction. So we wanna go ahead and put this person back into macro gifts. Boom, boom, boom. Now let's go to macro gifts. She should be available for the schedule. So let's go to Thursday. Let's put it down here. Make sure you put them on cash register. Do not put them on cleaning, or no one will be running the register and you'll lose money and you won't even realize it. As soon as 1800 hours hits, I'm gonna go ahead and take Tia off of the schedule and get her into training. And training over Thursday, Friday, it's gonna help improve a customer service, which is horrible right now. 37%, that is horrible. So let's go ahead and take her off of the business. Training will get her up to 47 and then 57. So she'll at least be above 50%, which will help our customer service quite a bit. This guy's at 71. I could do him one more time. I'm gonna go ahead and do him one more time. He's at the other business. That way to get him up to 81, I may even go two more times, honestly. Oh, I don't even have enough money to train him right now. Okay, well, he's going to have to be at 71% till we earn some more money at the end of the night. Then I throw him back in training, all right? We also got a call, and we do have a new hire. Customer service. He's at 46%, which is pretty good. Part-time, high. He still ended up being a part-time person. I may not hire this person. He wants a peaceful work environment. That's interesting. That's different. We're going to leave this person here. Once I make enough money, I may just tell them to recruit me another person. And we'll just go from there and see what their qualifications are and what their needs are, okay? Their demands. All right, cool. So we still making some money here. We making burgers. The rounded shelf is out, okay? That's still the same. All right, guys, so we're gonna keep grinding. I'm gonna get my money up, and then we'll get back to the main objective here of getting a purchasing agent and moving forward in our new headquarters, all right? See y'all in a minute. So guys, FYI, I opened up at 2 o'clock in the morning because once I hit that objective or something, my happiness was full, my energy was full, I didn't have to sleep long. So I said, let me just open up from like 2 in the morning to 10, and then I get with the daily duties and go ahead and carry on what I missed. All right, guys, one thing I needed that I didn't realize I needed for the burger shop is a trash bin. People try to discard trash, so you need a trash bin. One thing I want to get coming up in the near future is this industrial fryer as well. I want to sell French fries, just offer them more options so that we can make more money. I think you can fry donuts in that thing too. So that's just something for the future. But right now we're just getting a trash bin while we're out here. And I also stocked up on food. All right, cool. Another one of our employees just finished training. That is Tia. She's at 47%. We'll go ahead, we can do her 2 days. So this will get her to 57%. So we're gonna do that, and we're waiting on Travis. He should drop off here soon. I know it was in the evening. We'll also see how much our profits increase now that Michelle's training has increased quite a bit, and she should be much better with customer service being at 76%. We'll see if that helped increase our profits to like 2,000. We're at like 1,500, so if we get at 2,500. We also need to get some more inventory, but that's on the way. A trash bin on this side, on the far side, and they should be able to dump it out on their way out. All right, guys, we saved up enough money. I grinded multiple days, and we have enough money now to go ahead and finish out our objectives. We're gonna hire us a purchasing agent. I called the previous agency that we were dealing with, but they don't deal with like corporate hires. It's more like retail hires and things of that nature. So we're actually, the first time you deal with a business, you have to go to them the first time. Then usually you can call back and just place your orders there. You know, whether it's the wholesale places, office buildings, etc. The driving, etc. Yeah, you can call them once you visit that first time, establish the relationship, and then it appears you can call back. So we're heading out to this workforce place. We'll also need to go and get a few things from the IKEA type place they got here. And we need to get another desk, computer, you know, chair setup, which we will do. And then we'll assign that purchasing agent. Now I want to do this because you know it takes them about a day to find you someone, so we need to get in here, get to the next day, and then we'll have our purchasing agent. So let's find us an associate to speak with, a recruitment agent. What's up there, recruitment agent? Okay, so this is for our office. The recruitment agency doesn't have any available skills for the selected business. Okay, so we're doing macro industries and we need a purchasing agent. Now, I want a full-timer. Again, if you're trying to get full-timer, you want the highest percentage of it happening, take out the age group 15 through 30 and 51 plus. You want the 31 to 50 range. That's the age range to me where you're going to find the most people needing full-time work. 51 plus, they're reaching their retirement age. They'll probably want to be part-time, and the 15 to 30 will be part-time. Those are people in school, college, things of that nature. You still can get a full-timer here, and you still can get a part-timer here, but your chances are lessened. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go with two candidates. That'll be 1,000 for one day. Now, if you bring your days up, you can save a lot of money. How many can you do here? You could really check a lot of candidates if you have time. I'm gonna have to start thinking forward and utilizing those days. Just get them to send me candidates, but take about 5 days so it doesn't cost as much. We'll get to that though. We will get to that. So we're gonna go ahead and do 1,000. So we can see two different candidates. And if we like them both, we can just leave one in the queue. That's something you can do right now. You can just leave one in the queue. You don't have to hire them both. Just hire the one. Let's see, let's send the candidate. All right, cool. So we got our candidate. But yes, if you do choose two, don't think your money is wasted if you only hire one, because the other one would just sit there and you can hire them later. All right, guys, so I see y'all when we get back. I'm gonna head to the furniture spot, pick up the computer setup. Once I do that, I'm gonna head on over to HQ, so I see y'all there. All right, guys, so I am back at headquarters. Let's look at our office space real quick. Look at that. Macro industry, look at the sign. We need to redo our sign. All right, so we coming in, we gonna set up our first desk space. I'm gonna give them a window seat. We'll put them right there, replace the computer and the gaming chair. Boom. So we got the first spot for the agent. Now we're gonna rest. Once they get here tomorrow, we'll go ahead and assign them. You basically gotta put them on the schedule, and once you get them on the schedule, they'll be good to go, and we'll be done finished out this assignment. So it has been a long day smashing up my vehicle. I may take it and get repairs myself, because a lot of times if you let it get smashed up, you will have to get towed, and if you don't have the money, you shout. All right, guys, so we're checking with City Workforce. They've sent us Eliza Hill, $16 an hour, 29% on purchasing agent, which isn't great, but we're gonna go ahead and get them in place so we can move forward. They were supposed to send two people. I don't see the other person. Yeah, they want two candidates. So I guess I could wait to see the other one, see if they have a better purchasing agent percentage. They also don't show if they want to be full-time or not, which I don't like that. But maybe since it's a corporate office type job, they just automatically do 40 hours. Okay, Stephanie College, 19 an hour, 50, 43%. So we'll go ahead and hire this person. We'll keep Eliza in the queue. Don't hire her yet, but they'll stay there. They'll always be a candidate, but we will hire Stephanie. Boom. Let's go to my employees. Let's check her out. Now, I would normally, what I'm going to start doing is training all new hires, at least getting them above 50%, maybe even the 75, or max them out at 100. But for now, because we want to go ahead and complete this objective, we won't start her out hiring her. Okay, I had to play with this. Not the swaggiest outfit, but we're going to make it work. Let me see if I can change the color of them shoes. All right, you know, we're doing the corporate. We're going to do the outfit for the male and the female. Let's get this visor off of him. We suited and booted. Let's go. We'll do a generic name for that business type. So I did macro foods instead of doing burgers, hot dogs. That'll always be the uniform for food. Macro gifts, I may call that just macro retail. I'll rename it. For this one, we're gonna do macro offices. And this will just cover all office types. And what I'll do, I'll go back and adjust those other ones. So macro offices. Right now, it looks like people may either in the gift shop or the burger shop be serving in a suit. But that's how we do. We big time, baby. We big time. Okay, cool. Looks like it did that for all 5 days of the week. That's her 40 hours. Now, actually, if you do the share schedule for all days, we will go ahead and... Okay, the offices are incapable of unlocking Saturday and Sunday. So she's going to get straight 40 hours. Now, I think there are a couple of positions that will eventually allow us to work them on Saturday and Sunday, but not these positions. So we've got our next set of objectives, guys. We're gonna have to rent us a warehouse, and we're gonna start getting our own bulk inventory. That's what our purchasing agent will do. Work with warehouses, wholesalers, get us in bulk, so we'll stop going to these other more local wholesalers, and we're gonna save even more money, because we're probably gonna spend $2,000-$4,000 at a time on multiple or larger amounts of inventory for our businesses. All right, Guys, hit me in that comment box. Let me know what you think. Give me your opinions. Any tips, any tricks is always appreciated. If you haven't watched the first episode of the series, if you're just jumping in now, go back, check that out. Oh, it's been awesome, man. And thank you to everyone who's been commenting and giving me your input on this amazing title. Also, I have a video. You can check that out here. It's basically telling you in more detail why you'll enjoy this game if you're just jumping in. And yes, thank you for sticking around, guys. Hit that like button, subscribe. If you are not subscribed, share this so others can check it out. Thank you to my members. Thank you to my Patreons, my people who come through the stream, supporting that super chat. If you want to become a member, there are plenty of options for you to do that. It is much appreciated, but just being here is appreciated as well. So I thank you for that, all right? So we're going to come back in the next one, jump into these objectives. We'll do it all again. Charles Mackerel, Big Ambitions. Thank you for stopping through, and I'm going to holler at you. Peace.
I run the game. I run the game. I run the macro, my name. I run the game. I do this for the love, they love money and the fame.